हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ सी द अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर नाइन्थ क्लास, दैट इज द आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल. आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल, टू नो अबाउट इट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सी अ प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम्पल. ओके, सपोज इट इज अ बॉडी, एनी बॉडी इज सपोज सस्पेंडेड बाई अ थ्रेड. ओके, इट इज अ सॉलिड बॉडी, सपोज इट इज इन एयर. यू कैन सी इट्स टेंशन इन द स्ट्रिंग, यू विल फील अ टेंशन, मच टेंशन. ओके, why tension will produce? Due to its weight, due to weight of this solid. Now suppose the same solid is immersed in a liquid. Okay, suppose it is immersed in a liquid. Okay, it is a, suppose I am showing, suppose it is in a liquid immersed, then what will see, what you will see here, you will see that the elongation of the thread, it is the initial condition, the elongation, you can see the elongation is now decreased. Okay, means the tension will decrease. Suppose it is the T dash, and T dash it is always less than the T, so you will realize that there is a now less tension you are feeling in the thread. Why it is so? It is due to the upthrust force, because the liquid exerting a force in upward direction, so resultant force experienced by you will be now less. So Archimedes principle is given on the basis of this concept. Okay, so he states that Archimedes was the scientist, ki when a body immersed in a liquid, it experiences a force acting on it. Okay, and loss in its force, which type of force? Loss in its weight. Okay, and this loss in its weight is equal to the weight of liquid displaced by the solid. Okay, now try to understand again. Suppose it is a beaker. Okay, and then suppose the water is filled, completely filled up to the upper surface. Okay, like up to here. Okay, and if you immerse a solid in this liquid, then what will happen? You can guess. The water will come out, and suppose you collect the water here. If you collect the water here, you will find that the displaced water in a different container is always equal to the weight which is experiencing by this solid less. See in detail. Suppose the weight in air of the solid, suppose it is, you can say, 3 gram. Okay, 3 gram of weight this. Okay, and in the water, suppose when it is immersed, suppose in water its weight reduced by 2 gram. Okay, 2 gram, then the weight of the collected water, it will be the difference of these two, that is the 3 minus 2, that is the 1 gram water. Okay, so you will collect here. So this, again, when a body immersed in a solid, in a liquid, it will experience a loss in its weight. And that loss in its weight is always equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by it, displaced by the solid. Okay, so this is the Archimedes principle. Okay, and actually this is equal to the upthrust force also. This is equal to the upthrust force also. 1 gram is the upthrust here. Okay, so the displaced water is equal to the upthrust force also. So Archimedes principle, it is based on the flotation of the liquid. Okay, when the solid is immersed, it will experience a loss in its weight, and that loss in its weight is always equal to the weight of the liquid which is displaced by this solid. I think it is clear. So Archimedes principle has many applications. It's very important, the applications of the Archimedes principle. It's very, very important. That is, it is used in designing the ship. Okay, because it has to float on the surface. It is, and the submarines also, you can say submarines designing. And it is, Archimedes principle is used as in a lactometers to see the purity of the liquid, purity of the milk, etc. Lactometer, we can say. So, and it is also used in the hydrometers for determining the density of the hydrometers used to know the density of a liquid, any density. Okay, so all these three are based on the Archimedes principle. Dear friends, one more topic is left in this chapter, that is the relative density. Already you have discussed in class 7th. So relative density, it is termed as it is equal to the density of substance to the density of water. Simply try to understand, relative means it is a relation with the water density. Okay, so relative density, that is the density of any substance in comparison of the water. So that's why density of any substance, suppose the relative density of the silver. So what will be the formula? Relative density of the silver will be equal to the density of the silver upon density of water. I think it is clear. So, and since you can see it is the ratio of the same physical quantity, that's why it has no unit. So relative density has no unit. Why has no unit? Because it is a ratio. And one more thing you should know, that is the density of the water. Density of water, what is the value? Already you know, density of water, it is equal to the 1000 kilogram per meter cube. It is the density in SI unit. So I think it is clear, relative density, it is the density of the substance divided by or upon the density of water. Okay, suppose the density of iron you have to find. So relative density of iron is equal to the density of iron upon density of water. So you have to write the density of water downward direction here, and in upward it is the density of that particular substance. So it is the relative density. It's very useful to know the density of any substance. Thank you, friends.